Assalamu alaikum, Mr. Rins. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at your home place or residence where you live. Inshallah, Ameen. This is your English subject of class 9 and I am your teacher, Ms. Sobia Nas, from the Smart Schools of Sayyid Ahmed Khan campuses and Johar campus. Today we will discuss about your chapter number 10, Qaid-e-Azam and his vision for Pakistan. As we all know that I always make recorded videos of your chapter and poems in the form of question answers, so that you can easily understand that what is in your chapter or what your chapter is all about. For this you have to go through recorded video carefully. In this way you can easily be able to solve your subjective portion for the particular chapter. I hope you all understand and listen to the recorded video carefully. Let's start discussion. First, we have to know about Qaid-e-Azam. As we all know that Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah is the founder of our beloved homeland, Pakistan. He did many efforts for getting separate homeland in which all the Muslims can live freely according to their religion and their culture. He was considered one of the most dynamic personality of South Asia, who became one of the top barristers of Bombay. He not only famous among the Muslims, he is also famous among all the personalities of South Asia. He became one of the top barristers of Bombay and laid the foundation of Pakistan. And Qaid-e-Azam was born on 25th December 1876. We all every year pay tribute to this legendary person who did so much for Pakistan. He is no longer with us, but has left for our guidance his three watchwords: unity, faith and discipline. With the help of unity, we can achieve anything in the world. We can realize the world or the society that Muslims do exist. The faith, we had to have faith in our religion. We had to have faith in our feelings that we can achieve each and everything, as Qaid-e-Azam did. And discipline. Without discipline, you cannot be able to achieve anything in the society. For the successful achievement of anything, you have to be very disciplined in your own. Why do we call him Qaid-e-Azam? The word Qaid-e-Azam is the combination of two words, Qaid, which means the leader, and Azam, which means great. So it's a combination of two words, leader or the great leader. The title was given to Mr. Muhammad Ali Jinnah by the Muslims of South Asia. You know, all the Muslims of South Asia gave this title to Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah for his glorious services to the Muslim of subcontinent, because he fought till end to have separate homeland in which all the Muslims lived freely according to their religion and culture. Why is Qaid-e-Azam called the best ambassador? Muhammad Ali Jinnah was the only leader of British India who was popular not only among the Muslims but also had a great respect among the people of other faiths. As I have told you before, not only Muslims gave respect to that person, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, but because of his glorious or popular leadership, he was, or even now, he is popular among all other faiths like Hindus, Christians, Sikhs, and Parsis. This was the reason that a Hindu leader, Mr. Gokhale, and a famous Hindu poetess, Sarojini Naidu, used to praise him as the best ambassador of Hindu-Muslim unity. What did Qaid-e-Azam say about the liberty of religions? As the first elected presidents of the Constituent Assembly of Pakistan, the Qaid-e-Azam declared, "You are free." As we all know that we got this homeland on the basis of free to perform our religious sentiments, the Qaid-e-Azam declared, "You are free. You are free to go to your temples." Sorry, there is a mistake in the spelling of "your." You are free to go to your masjid or to any other place of worship in this state of Pakistan. You can freely follow up your religion, whatever religion you are belonging. You can freely fulfill your religious sentiments. You may belong to any religion or caste or creed that has nothing to do with the business of the state. Okay, we don't have any concern with that religious point of thing regarding business of the state. We are starting in the days when there is no discrimination. Now we are in that situation, or now we are in place where there is no discrimination, no distinction between one community and another. We are starting with this fundamental principle that we are all citizens and equal citizens of the state of Pakistan. Whether we are Muslims, whether we are Christians, whether we are Hindu, we all are same. How can Pakistan become one of the greatest nation according to Qaid-e-Azam? The Qaid-e-Azam said on August 11, 1947, "My guiding principle will be justice and complete impartiality." This is the basic reason why we got this homeland, or why all the personalities, all the national personalities decided to have a separate homeland on the basis of complete justice and impartiality. Because in subcontinent, all the Muslims are suppressed by the Hindus, not to fulfill their religious beliefs, not even they are not getting that proper education as they wanted to. And I am sure with this complete justice and impartiality, your support and coordination, I can look forward to Pakistan becoming one of the greatest nation of the world. By exempting these two, or by, you know, considering these two important points, to have justice in the nation and complete impartiality, we will become the greatest nation of the world, inshallah. What was the Qaid-e-Azam greatest achievement? The greatest achievement of Qaid-e-Azam was our beloved homeland, Pakistan. He did so much to get this homeland, Pakistan. We got freedom in 1947 under his wise leadership. As we all know that to some extent it seems impossible without having Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah's great vision or political sense to have this separate homeland. He will always be remembered as the founder of Pakistan, for sure. How can we pay homage to Qaid-e-Azam? मोहम्मद अली जिन्ना। वी कैन पे होमेज टू कायद आज़म बाई फॉलोइंग हिज फुटस्टेप्स एंड ट्रांसफॉर्म्स पाकिस्तान इनटू अ कंट्री वेयर एवरी सिटीजन मे लिव विद द स्पिरिट ऑफ पीस। ठीक है, इफ़ वी डू नॉट सप्रेस the sentiments of other religions, if we allow them to take education according to their will, the Pakistan will become a place where all the people live in peace, brotherhood and harmony. I hope this topic is clear to you all. For this, I want to tell you one thing: do watch your recorded videos because it will be helpful in your understanding and learning of the chapter or poem, whatever you have in your book. Till your next recorded class, I hope you will be fine. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Thank you.